Today on Knife Banter, we're going to be looking at some very gentlemanly knives. What is up, guys? Today at Blade HQ, we're looking at a whole bunch of gentlemen's knives. Zach, what's the plan with this?
The plan with this is to go through all these gentlemen knives, see what fits good in a suit pocket, see what will make you look classy, see what type of accoutrement a real gentleman wants.
Is that a French word?
It's a, I don't know, I just made it up.
I know words, I have the best words.
But I like that.
It's probably
like
a real word.
So here's the deal, guys. We've heard from you all that occasionally you wear a suit. Some of you wear a suit all the time. What knife do you carry when you wear a suit or you're wearing slacks, that sort of thing? So that's what we're going to be going into today. The first on the list is the Kershaw Almar. And I forget the number on this one. It's the AM3 on this particular model. Now, here's the deal. We went from least expensive to most expensive over here on this side. This one, you've got HCR13 MOV steel. You've got a G10 handle. Is that G10 or micarta?
I actually think it is...
Struggling.
G10. It is G10.
Cool. Sometimes it's hard to tell.
Yeah.
Deep carry pocket clip on this thing.
It's low key, right? It's got a little bit of flare in the back spacers here.
Yep.
It's sleek. That's another thing with the gentleman's knife is you guys will notice on the table, all these options are sleek. And the reason is the slack pockets, right? Generally, they're slippery.
Yeah.
And they're usually tight against the leg when you sit down.
Yeah.
So you don't want this knife like bulging out of your pocket, right?
So, I mean, if you look at this one versus the next one, the next one's the CRKT Crossbones. You're looking at a thin profile. And I think a lot of that just has to do with slacks are typically fit a little bit tighter.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have a lot of creases and folds to work with those. Especially in today's society, the front creases are gone away.
Gone, yep.
For the moment, so.
Yeah, they'll be back. That's how fashion works.
Yeah, it is. What do you think about the Crossbones, Zach?
I actually really like the Crossbones, personally. It's got a good design, nice pocket clip. It's Oz 8 blade. So again, you know, the two blade steels on these two, not anything to necessarily write home about, but if you're the type of guy who only wears a suit every 2 years, like Jamie, our video guy, you don't necessarily need a baller steel, right? You just need something that can go into a pair of slacks you're comfortable with, and they work
Should we talk slacks for a minute?
Let's talk slacks for a minute.
Here, we're just going to get all fancy here. So, and I don't know if you'd qualify this as a gentleman's knife or not.
No, definitely not.
We'll talk about that in a minute.
It's a slim carry, yeah.
But the pants... You can see there, it's a vertical pocket on slacks, folks. So typically your pocket's gonna be more of an angle like that. This is a vertical pocket. So anything sitting in there has really gotta be slim, because if it's big, you're gonna have a bulge in your pocket.
Yeah, right? And then there's all the jokes, you know, that go along
all
with that.
All the jokes, you can put them in the comments.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Typically there are children watching, but I like that Crossbones, and I think generally, to me, a gentleman's knife must be slim.
Yeah, I agree.
Like, I think that's part of it.
I agree. And so for me, the reason that I like a slim gentleman's knife, I actually don't carry them in my slack pockets.
Okay.
Because anywhere I go, I always have basically the same exact items in my pocket. So what I do is I go for the suit jacket.
Okay.
So I got my book that I always keep. I got my pen that I always keep. And then on this side is where I'll put I got a pocket light all the time, and my knife, which I don't
have
in there.
So you don't carry things in your pockets when you're wearing a suit?
Never, because they always fall out. So I'm in a suit at least once a week.
Yeah.
And I find that, like, if I'm trying to be comfortable and put my feet up or something, everything in my pocket
just
dumps.
So you're going here.
I go there.
Right there.
Yep, every time.
Every time.
Yeah. Doesn't bother me.
Occasionally I'll do that if something's falling out.
Yeah.
But for the most part, I go pocket.
Yep.
I go pocket. This is another beautiful knife, kind of in that gentleman's category, and I think it fits all of what you're saying here. This is the Brad Zinker Boker. Man, that name is gone. Urban Trapper. Holy smokes. We haven't had this one out in a minute.
But it is a really great knife. I really like this one a lot.
Why do you like it?
I like the fit and finish of it a lot.
Yeah.
I like the pocket clip on it. That it's not a loud pocket clip, but it is deep carry.
Yeah.
Which is really nice.
Stone washed too.
Yeah. Nice. Stone washed. And then it's a VG10 blade, so we're starting to get into a little bit of a better blade steel there as well.
Price point on this one currently you're going to run about $70.
Yeah.
And those change, so check it on the website.
And this particular one I like because of the bling with the Coca Bolo.
I think that's really beautiful, and they've executed it really well. in the sense that you've got the beautiful stonewashed sort of feel with the Coca Bola. And I think that's nice. So that I like that one. I've debated about that one before.
Yeah.
So much that I forgot its name.
So much that I forgot its name. But this is again, and that's right with the crossbones and how thin it is and how sleek it is, and it is a little bit of a longer blade.
Sure.
So the next one is the Benchmade Proper. And this is a slip joint, so you're going not only into the gentleman's category, but definitely into that traditionals category as well, starting to touch the traditionals category. You've got, S30V steel blade with the micarta handle, which I really like. Kind of the same thing with the Urban Trapper. I like that it's a little bit of bling on the handle, something a little unexpected. Looks nice.
Do you like a slip joint?
I don't.
Me neither.
I don't. And
people love this.
Yeah. And I think slip joints are great, and I have no like beef against them.
I have a scar against them.
Yeah, no, that's what I was gonna say. The reason that I don't like it is I don't know if you guys can see it on camera, but this thumb is round and this thumb is flatter, and that's because I cut a chunk of my thumb off with a slip joint.
Should we compare scars? So,
yeah.
Look at that. You see that? And let's be honest, like, this is a great knife, and if you use it properly and you're not a 12-year-old kid at scout camp,
exactly,
you're not going to end up with a scar.
Yep.
But slip joints make me nervous.
Yeah, they make me nervous. But this is a really great knife. It does feel good in hand. We've used it around the office a ton.
Yeah.
Yeah, everybody absolutely. But our photo guy really loves that knife.
Can I throw in a wild card?
Dude, let's throw in a wild card.
So I pulled this out of, I probably shouldn't put it that way. No, I'll just say it. I pulled this out of CRKT's warranty when I worked there.
Okay.
They have a huge bucket of just warrantied knives, and I saw this one, I'm like, dang, that's nice. It's discontinued, it's CM1600K. This, to me, is a gentleman's knife.
Wrong, 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 wrong. Wrong, 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 wrong.
I think visually, maybe not so much.
As I say, visually, it's bordering on that kind of tactical.
Yeah, absolutely.
Right?
Yeah. But check this out. Look at the slim profile on both of those. So you're not taking up a ton of pocket space on this guy. And I think, for me at least, that's what qualifies it as a gentleman's knife, is it slim, is it pocket friendly when you're wearing a suit? I don't know that there's any definitive definition of what a gentleman's knife is out there.
I don't think there's a definitive definition, but I have to argue against this one being a gentleman's knife because...
Really?
I think that it's got a...
Sorry. No violence. We never do violence on this show.
I think that it has to have... A little bit of bling, a little bit of something refined about it. And this, it's a great knife, but it doesn't look refined.
You're talking to a guy who wears a Timex watch.
But that's what we're talking about. We're talking about gentlemen.
I know, but can't I carry whatever I want?
Oh, yeah, totally.
To church or to a social function?
Yeah.
And can't that be a gentleman's knife? Do I have to have a gentleman's knife?
You could carry a full-blown Medford if you wanted to, but I think to start classifying it as a gentleman's knife, it's got some things. Slim. Good in the pocket, can go here or can go here, depending on the pocket, and it's a little pretty. It's got
a little beauty to it. We're going
to
come back and debate this more after the commercial break.
All right, guys, so we have a lot of great gentleman's knives on the table, but if you want to add a little bit of extra classiness to your life or a little extra pop to that new suit you just got, you should go with a custom. At BladeHQ.com, we have over 400 customs in stock, like this Marfione Custom SOCOM Elite, or if you're lucky, tomorrow you could wake up in this new Todd Begg Begotti. I woke up in a new Bugatti. So check out what we've got. Let's get back to the table. All right, well, welcome back from commercial break. And since Ben just isn't feeling refined today, he's not feeling like a gentleman apparently, I'm gonna give him the Kaiser Feist.
No, I hate you.
Because he loves those front flippers.
Okay, you ready for this, guys? I've been practicing.
Here we go.
Did you see that wrist flick?
I saw the wrist flick.
So this is the Kaiser Feist. It's a beautiful knife, fantastic design by Justin Lundquist. And it has that fantastic front flipper that I just struggle with, guys. If I do the wrist flick, I do it great.
Yeah.
But if not, it's a struggle. Titanium handle, I believe it's S30V steel?
It's 35 VN.
35 VN, beautiful. So this is a solid piece. And to me, yeah, I'll make this argument, but this has this, like the pivot, there's pieces of this that just say I'm classy.
Yeah.
Where the...
And this
will never say I'm classy.
This is the other thing. If you're in a situation where you need a gentleman's knife, right? Like, let's say you're in a suit, right? You're at a business thing, you're at church, you're at whatever, right?
Wherever the opera.
The opera, a wedding, whatever reason you have to put a suit on. You go and you pull out something like the proper, right? And it's, you know, two-handed, doesn't feel aggressive or anything like that. You pull out that M16. And again, I love this knife, but for a gentleman's knife, you pull this out and you're now immediately out of place.
You are.
You pull out that Feist.
That's true.
Pull out that Feist. Yeah. That vice belongs at the opera, right?
So you can sit there at the opera and struggle
and
with it?
And struggle with it.
I know you guys are great at that. I am not. In fact, somebody tagged me on Instagram one day and they're like, hey, Ben, watch this.
That's great.
I think that's a great knife. It's a solid one.
All right.
You do the next one. It's easy.
Okay, this one's easy. Yeah, you're right. So this is the ProTec Newport. This is the tuxedo version of it. And deep carry pocket clip, nice black blade. Obviously, the tuxedo pattern, very gentlemanly there. Now, going back to aggressive, this could be a knife, though. Great gentleman's knife.
Oh, absolutely.
But, you know, those automatics, sometimes people...
I think autos are inherently
People kind of get this thing about them. Yeah. And so... But I still think it's a great gentleman's knife.
Yeah.
Nice and slim, looks good, and it wouldn't be out of place at a, you know, black tie event.
You know, I've heard a lot of people ask in the past, I need some groomsmen's knives. And I think anything on the table here, just depending on your budget, would be a great groomsman knife.
Yeah.
But you look at this thing, and this thing wants to be at a wedding. Mm-hmm. Like, this is something that you hand to your three best friends and say, hey, thanks for being at my wedding, you know. Like,
totally.
Thanks for 20 years of friendship and being at my wedding. Like, I think this one... just says classy to the max.
Yeah.
So.
It's a great knife.
It is. Okay, and last on the list here, guys, is the Chris Reeve Mnundi. There's two N's in there, which I think makes sense in South African, but to me it doesn't. Nice thing about a suit, so when I opened this, I smudged it. I love wearing a suit for this reason.
Right.
Boom.
Clean that polish.
So this is a Chris Reeve Knives Mnundi. Beautiful carbon fiber inlay. This is a Blade HQ exclusive. And I think when it comes to classy of all classy, this is probably it. It's a $400 knife.
Yeah.
And I think if you're a true classy person, you know that when you pay $400 for something, you're getting $400 of value. And I think this knife really has that value in it. It's just done extremely well. The tolerances are perfect on it. The action is perfect. And it's just a beautiful piece. In fact, I feel bad even getting my sweaty fingerprints on there.
Well, and it hits a lot of, I mean, when we look at what we have on the table, right? Moving out of budget, because obviously this is not a budget knife. It kind of has everything that you're looking for with a gentleman's knife, right?
Yeah.
Like it's a little blingy, right? It's got a little bit of style to it. It's got a great pocket clip. It's a two-handed opener, but it locks, right?
Yeah.
Like all these things.
I think you could make a debate for a gentleman's knife shouldn't have a pocket clip.
Right.
I'm in the camp that I just like pocket clips a lot.
I know! You know. I know. I got it.
I got the concept.
And so I feel like having a pocket clip on this particular knife, you could remove it if you wanted, but...
Totally.
To me, it's nice to have it to know exactly where it is. If you were going to carry it here...
Yep. Now it's there.
Now it's there. And that actually looks like a pen.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. That's another great thing with the Mnundi is that pocket clip is very unassuming.
It
right?
is.
And
Absolutely.
So it would fit in with like a nice watch and some cufflinks or a tie clip.
A nice watch like a Timex?
Yeah, like your beautiful Timex.
Yeah, like that.
Exactly.
I'm like the world's non-classy person of all time. I think there's a way to dress classy, and there's also a way to act classy.
There you go.
I hope I act classy.
There you go.
But I actually don't own a single true gentleman's knife because I think, to me, things should be multi-use.
Yeah.
In some ways, yeah, you could carry these anywhere, but I don't want to go camping with this.
Right. Yeah, so, this could definitely go camping, but I would feel bad taking
I would
it
too.
Camping.
Like, you'd bring it back, and it smells like smoke, and you're like...
Yeah.
It just doesn't jive. But I think these are beautiful knives. Let us know in the comments what you think about gentlemen's knives and if you carry one. Now, we got a couple last minutes here for mailbag.
Mailbag.
From you guys. You! We got Assassin JCHR, RH, teach us how to get more money to buy more knives from Blade HQ. Now, Zach, you said you knew a way to get more money.
Yeah, I actually have a really good, just send me your mother's maiden name, your social security number to marketing@bladehq.com, and I've got a great deal for you. You won't be able to pass it up.
Is that with the Nigerian prince?
Yeah, my buddy that I was telling you about.
Dear sir, it has come to pass that the great king of Nigeria, Koftu Kambawi, has passed on. I've secured his finances, which is $12 million.
Spam. We got, that sounds like really good.
Ben's already invested. A couple guys around the office have already invested. It's safe, completely safe.
Don't do that.
Don't do it.
Do it.
We got The next one is from Jorge Ordaneta. He says, I know this is expensive and time-consuming, but please, guys, more videos like this, referring to our Bowie knife video from a couple weeks ago. You are right. It is expensive and time-consuming, but we have a lot of fun, and we appreciate you guys watching them and then buying knives from BladeHQ, because at the end of the day, the knives that you buy from us pay for more fun productions like this. And we got ideas coming out our noses and our ears, so it's fun.
Next up, from Cameron Hullett. Matthew is low-key the biggest meme lord ever.
I may have gone too far in a few places.
We got...
Yeah, he is, actually.
That's true.
He's amazing, and we love him.
He's a good sport. We give him a lot of guff here in the office. I've been placing plastic lizards around his cubicle for like four months now.
Honey, you've got a big storm coming.
We got, it's amazing.
Yeah.
And the last one. What does Zach hide under his beanie? Ta-da! Just hair.
Just hair. Nothing fancy.
Why do you wear the beanie, Zach?
Because it's cold in Utah. And like, I've seen comments that are like, he's always got the beanie on and they're inside. But this room actually gets really, you can attest to this. Yeah. This room actually gets really cold. You'll notice in the wintertime, Ben always got a jacket on in here.
Because it's freezing.
It's cold. So yeah, and I, in the winter I wear my hair really long to keep my head warmer.
Yeah.
So for Knife Banner, I'll just throw a beanie
on. Then you don't have to do your hair.
Exactly.
Beautiful thing. Yeah. Guys, thanks for watching. If you like this video, definitely give it a thumbs up. Comment down below on Gentleman's Knives, and we'll have another video coming out for you next week.
Oh my gosh, no. I think we can talk about it without showing it.
I think we need to show it.
I am so glad I got that on camera.